Hello and welcome to Ghostmakers Workshop. This episode is going to be dedicated to the fitting of the BSA side wheel focus to my BSA Scorpion. I'm going to show you the correct mounting procedures and a few little tips I've picked up along the way to get the gun shooting how it should. First of all, we're going to be taking a look at the items that I'm going to be using. Okay, this is the BSA side wheel focus 8-32x44. This is the scope that I've chosen to fit to my HFT BSA Scorpion. And this is also the scope that I've been using in the HFT Extreme on my BSA R10. This is my BSA Scorpion that has been blueprinted by John Bowkett. It's in a Gin B number 7 stock. This will be the rifle that I'm fitting the BSA side wheel focus to. These are the mounts I will be using. They are a pair of medium sports match BSA fitment double screw mounts. You will need the correct Allen keys, both sizes for the clamp and the top of the ring. This is a spirit level bubble, and this one is from line level. You can buy these at your local DIY superstore. They come with a yellow piece of plastic around them. They're very easily separated from the plastic. I think this one cost me about £1, and you use this to make sure that the action of the rifle is level. The other item that you will need is a plumb line. You'll be able to get this from your local builder's merchant, Screwfix Direct, Tool Station, one of those places. They're a couple of quid, and they really are for when you're doing this scope. They're a great tool for helping to get the reticle aligned correctly. And next I will show you how we hang this up, and we'll get this set up and we'll get the scope on the gun. Okay, right, here we are. Well, I think we've gone through everything we need to go through up to this point. Let's get the scope fitted to the gun now. The plumb line, which I've just shown you, this is it here. My scope's minimum focus range is 8 yards. So to do this must be set up away from where you're going to have your gun on a rest at a minimum of 8 yards. You might find your scope is slightly more. You might find that you need 10 yards or 13 yards or so on. Some scopes will only focus down at 15 yards, for instance, but that will be something that is specific to your scope. For me, 8 yards is fine, and for demonstration purposes, I'm going to be doing it inside, so I'm not actually going to have 8 yards, but I think if I go the other side of the room, it will be clear enough for me to get the crosshair straight on this. Okay, so there's your line on the wall. I've got it hanging on a picture hook up here. The weight, the plumb line weight, is dragging this absolutely straight towards gravity. And that's the plane that you want the centre of your crosshair to follow. Provided you've bubbled your gun up correctly, like we're going to do in a minute, you know that your scope and your gun are going to be in 100% in the vertical plane. So, let's go to the gun, we'll do the next part. Okay, now we have everything we need. Close to hand, I've got my toolbox here if there's anything that I've missed. My shooting box here with all my gun related tools and stuff's in. Got the scope out of the box, ready to go on. Just had a look at that, smashing bit of kit. There will be a review of the 8-32x44 on the Air Rifle Hunter review channel. Within the next couple of weeks. It's a fantastic scope. I've got one of these, exactly the same scope, on my BSA R10. I'm using it for the Hunter Field Target Extreme series, and currently I'm running 9th overall in that series with this scope. That's why I bought another one. Fantastic scope. There's the sports match mounts. Got my Allen keys and my level, which we're going to be needing in a sec. So I'm just going to fast forward through these bits. Let's get the gun together. Okay, now we're at the point where we need to determine our eye relief. I think the eye relief on this scope is about 1.5 to 1.75 inches. And eye relief, for those of you who don't know, is the distance between the eyebell and your eye. Where a lot of people go wrong when they're setting up a scope, they just strap it to the gun and then they move their head around to suit the way the scope is set up. You don't want to do that. At this point now, we're going to move the scope around so that it fits us. So what we're going to do, we're going to lift the rifle up into position, and without thinking about the scope at all, we're just going to grip the gun and put our head on the stock in the natural position that it falls in. And then we're going to adjust how far the scope is away from our eye so that it matches us, not we match it. Okay, right, just I wanted to point out before I do it, I've just finger tightened the bottom of the scope mounts to the rail, so they're on finger tight, and these are nice and loose so that if I need to slide the scope backwards or forwards, I can. At this starting point, it is ideal if you have your scope rings in the middle of these gaps. And that way you've got quite a lot of travel forwards and backwards for making this adjustment. Okay, so take the rifle. Don't concentrate on the scope at all. Just pick the rifle up and put the gun where your head falls naturally. That was a little too close. Right, that feels pretty good there. Lift it up. Right, okay, feels like it could go a little further forward. Now she's starting to feel right. That's it, that's coming up in the correct position every time now. So what I will do now, I'm going to tightly pinch that one down. I'm going to hold the scope in position at that distance, and I'm going to move the scope rings back into these center sections again. Same with the back, hold the scope on the ring, slide that up into the center position. This ensures that the scope rings are spread nicely and that they're gripping in the centers of these parts of the scope tube. Right, okay, we're almost at the point where we're going to level the gun and the reticle. We've set our eye relief, so now there'll be a constant and correct distance between our natural head alignment and the eyebell. At this point, we're just going to pinch these down just ever so gently. And I must stress the golden rule with scope fitting is gently. Gently. Never ever use the Allen key by the long end and crank these down. All you're going to do is break your scope. A scope with a double screw like this with the four screws on these rings, all they will need is just pinching gently with finger and thumb on this end. And if all four screws are pinched down like that, both sides, I would be very, very surprised if it would move. It definitely won't if with with a knock on a pre-charged rifle. Unless you knock it quite hard, it's not going to move. You may find that you'll get a little bit of creep on a springer, on a spring rifle with a hard kickback. You might do them up ever so slightly more. But my scope rings are only ever just gently pinched down, and that's absolutely critical if you do not want to damage your scope. Okay, next up, we're going to level the gun. Okay, to do this, we take the line level bubble and we pop it behind the first scope mount across the breech of the rifle, across the rear of the breech for action, and then tweak the rifle on your rest. For this, I'm using the Deben Pro Bench Rest. Attention to detail here will make a big difference when you're shooting at different ranges. Okay, nearly there. Right, okay, well that is absolutely spot on now. I'm going to bring the camera around the back of the rifle and show you the level. Okay, hopefully this will illustrate the bubble, the level across the top of the block. I know the action. Okay, guys and girls, we are in the home straight. Thank God I hear you all say. Right, I've just had to move the gun over, so I'm just going to check the level again, because the floor in this room is terrible. Right, that's absolutely spot on. Now, without moving the rifle, which is somewhat tricky, parallax, I'm just parallaxing the rifle down to its minimum focusing distance. And it looks like that has been set up for somebody else's eye, not mine. I usually have the diopter right the way in. That's better. Okay. Let's check to make sure everything's level again. Looking through the scope. Now, I can see through the scope that the vertical crosshair, the crosshair is like that in your scope, the vertical crosshair is absolutely 100% in line with the plumb line on the wall. Once you've determined that your gun is level and that your reticle, the horizontal part of your reticle, is 100% in line with the plumb line, which you know is 100% vertical, you know then that your scope will be 100% spot on. And I think I just said 100% about four times. So I'm just going to gently tighten these down until they hit the stop. Another thing I like to do, I do like to keep the gaps both sides as even as possible. I'm not saying that that's a golden rule, but it's something I like to do. And I'm not saying that this is the way you must set your scope up, but this is how I do mine. And I think you could do a lot worse than following this example. So there you go. Finally, that little quarter turn there is all I'm doing to tighten the scope. That one actually needed a little bit more. That is all I'm doing though. Just gently pinching these up. Like so. There we are. Almost there. Gently taking up the slack. And there's no way you can really teach this. It's just something you get used to, what is enough. So there we go.